the Statue of Liberty, the symbol of freedom and liberty and America and everything that's great about this country. There she is, Lady Liberty, standing there in all of her blue-green glory. But she wasn't supposed to be this color. The Statue of Liberty was a gift from France back in 1885 as a way of commemorating our fight for independence and their own aspirations towards democracy. This 305-foot statue was built over 9 years in sections of copper skin on top of an iron skeleton. According to the National Park Service, the statue has about 30 tons of copper, which is enough to make 435 million pennies. Yes, bright reddish gold pennies. But the Statue of Liberty isn't the same color as, well, any penny I've ever seen. So, how to explain Lady Liberty's color change? Simple. You'd change colors too if you stayed outside in that New York City polluted air for almost 150 years. I'm kidding. Well, mostly. It all comes down to chemistry. During her first few decades in the Big Apple, the statue slowly turned from that shiny copper color to a dull brown, and then finally to the blue-green, or as they say back in France, verdigris, that we see today. Officials suggested trying to restore her to the original color or painting her, but after public outcry, they decided to leave her the way she is. And she'll continue to look like that until Dr. Zayas shows up. Anyway, her color change happened because of oxidation reactions between copper and the air. Now I know some of you smarty pants might be saying, well, duh, but copper's patina is more complicated than just one reaction. It's due to about 30 years worth of oxidation reactions creating a mixture of minerals. So let's get into it. Now, when an atom loses electrons in a chemical reaction, it's called oxidation. This process was first observed in reactions that involved oxygen, hence the name, but it can happen with other elements too. The color change from coppery red to blue-green was bound to happen as soon as they parked her in New York Harbor. And here's why. First, there's all the oxygen in our atmosphere, just hungry for electrons. Then you add all the elements in New York's polluted air into the mix and voila! In the first reaction, copper gives up electrons to oxygen. That creates this mineral, cuprite, which you can see is a pinkish red. Next, cuprite loses more electrons to more oxygen, forming blackish tannerite. The black color of this tannerite explains why the statue slowly got darker over the years. Now, let's pivot to sulfur reactions. Sulfur finds its way into the atmosphere through natural processes, including volcanic eruptions. But humans have also put a lot of it there too, with their boats and cars and pesky airplanes and factories. So when sulfur dioxide gets together with water, it forms sulfuric acid, which can form green stuff with copper oxides. Now, back to our color change. Lady Liberty gets painted with the sulfuric acid and her green color gets forming. Throw in some chloride from the sea spray around the statue's Ellis Island home, and well, you see what happens. Here's the chemistry breakdown. Tannerite, that black stuff, reacted with sulfuric acid and water to make blue-green brochantite. And thanks to New Yorkers, there was even more sulfuric acid in the air. So the brochantite became green antlerite in some places on the statue. Whenever the sea spray hit the Statue of Liberty and didn't get washed away by rain, brochantite sulfate got swapped for chloride and made olive green atacamite. So there it is, the beautiful and well-known blue-green hue. The Statue of Liberty has stayed this color for over 100 years because the exposed copper is now oxidized, and at this point of her life, she's stable. At least until she decides to take a walk. Anyway, the Statue of Liberty wouldn't be the same if she lived anywhere else. If nothing else, she has a New Yorker's thick skin, and it's helped protect her over these years. So, what do you think? Should Lady Liberty stay the blue-green color of freedom, or return to her glorious brown color? Let us know in the comments, and just one more thing. We have a message for you from our friend Vanessa at Braincraft.
Hey guys, I'm Vanessa, the host of Braincraft, a show about psychology and neuroscience and why you act the way you do. It's nice to meet you. I'd love you to come over to Braincraft and check out what it's all about. Link down in the doobly-doo.